The Cutler-Beard flap is a technique that is used to reconstruct large defects in the upper lid. Typically, defects that are larger than 75% of the eyelid are amenable to this technique, which was first described in 1955 by two plastic surgeons, Norman Cutler and Crowell Beard. The technique therefore still bears their name, the Cutler-Beard technique. In case a large upper lid defect is created due to the excision of a large tumor, a skin muscle conjunctival flap is fashioned in the lower lid, keeping a bridge of tarsal tissue intact. This flap is then slid underneath the bridge of tissue and is approximated with the upper lid wound edges. This covers the defect, and after a certain healing period, the lid is split into two, creating the upper lid. In this video, we describe the case of a 45-year-old female with a left upper eyelid mass. 4 millimeters of clear margin is measured and marked. Traction sutures are then taken to keep the lid stretched. Along the markings, an incision is made either with a blade or with radio frequency cautery. This is a full thickness incision that is made and the mass is excised, thereby creating the colobomatous defect. Corresponding to the size of the defect in the upper eyelid, an advancement flap is fashioned in the lower lid. This skin muscle conjunctival full thickness flap is in the shape of an inverted U. Care should be taken not to damage the tarsal plate of the lower lid while creating this flap. The flap is then pushed through underneath the bridge of tarsal tissue and then separated into the anterior and the posterior laminae. The conjunctiva is dissected off this flap and is sutured to the conjunctival edges of the upper lid wound. The first sutures to be taken are the ones at the edges. These bites are lamellar and not full thickness, such that they do not rub the ocular surface. At the central conjunctival suture, one may choose to incorporate a stump of the upper lid levator in it. The skin and the orbicularis are then closed in layers. It is important to suture the lateral edges of the advancement flap to the remnants of the tarsus on either side of the upper eyelid. Here is the patient immediately after the stage 1. 4 to 6 weeks are given for epithelialization and wound healing, following which the flap is then separated. The incision is made with electrocautery in a downwardly convex shape. The eyelid is separated differentially such that excess conjunctiva is incorporated into the upper eyelid. This conjunctiva at the edge of the wound would later on be turned upward to reform the upper eyelid margin. Formation of the lower lid involves freshening of the wound edges such that on suturing the wound heals completely. The orbicularis and the skin are closed in layers. The conjunctiva typically heals with granulation. final step is using the upper lid conjunctiva to create the lid margin. The conjunctiva is rolled back and sutured to cover the cut end of the skin and the orbicularis, thus creating a mucocutaneous junction for the upper eyelid margin. Therefore, Cutler Beard procedure is an effective, simple, and reproducible technique to address upper eyelid tissue loss.